Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. And this is module number 1, Basics of Thermodynamics and Zeroth Law. And this is lecture number 3 on the module 1. And we recap from the previous lectures. So in the previous 2 lectures, we discussed the thermodynamic system and the various types of thermodynamic system, intensive and extensive properties, thermodynamic equilibrium. So that the thermodynamic equilibrium includes the mechanical equilibrium, chemical equilibrium, thermal equilibrium, and quasi-static process. So quasi-static means almost static process, or all the quasi-static processes are reversible processes. And here in the 3rd lecture, we discuss the pure substance, we define the pure substance, and we discuss various thermodynamic properties. We discuss about the pressure and its measurement. We define Zeroth law of thermodynamics, and we will talk about the temperature. And the learning outcome for this lecture, so at the end of the lecture, student will be able to define the pure substance, define various thermodynamic properties, and the student will be able to describe the types of pressure and state the Zeroth law of thermodynamics and rewrite the temperature scale. In engineering, all the matter, all the substances, they exist in 3 forms: solid form, liquid form, and the gaseous form. And the pure substance, a substance which has fixed chemical composition throughout, is called as a pure substance. What do you mean by the throughout? So in all the 3 forms, whether this is in the solid form, liquid form, or gaseous form, in all the 3 forms, the chemical composition or chemical equation should be the standard, should be fixed. The examples for pure substance: water, nitrogen, helium, carbon dioxide. And which is familiar, known example to us is water. So we know water is available in solid form, that is ice, water, liquid form, and in the vapor form or gaseous form, water vapor, so steam. So water in the solid form, it is ice, in the vapor form, it is water vapor or the steam. In all the 3 forms, the chemical equation is, chemical formula for water is H2O. So that is what the pure substance. Similarly for nitrogen, helium, and carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide liquid, carbon dioxide in the gaseous form, and we can cool to the very low temperature, then you can make it to solid. Then thermodynamic properties. We defined the thermodynamic properties earlier. So any characteristics of the system is called as property. The pressure, volume, temperature. So the system is defined by the property, by the characteristics. So those characteristics are called as properties. So properties are 2 types. We know the intensive property and the extensive property. The property which are independent of the mass in the system are called as intensive properties. For example, pressure, density, velocity, temperature, specific volume, specific energy, and specific entropy. So these are all the intensive properties. Specific volume, specific energy, and specific entropy, they are per unit volume, so per unit mass. So that is why they are called, they are also called as independent properties. Are the property which are dependent on the mass of the system, mass in the system, are called as extensive properties. For example, volume and energy. And density. So density is defined as mass per unit volume, mass of the fluid over unit volume. So mass divided by volume, it is in kilograms per meter cube. And specific weight is defined as weight per unit volume. So weight divided by volume is specific weight, which is mg into mg divided by v. The unit is newtons per meter cube. And specific volume, it is 1 by the density. So if you look at the definition, it is 1 by the density, volume by the mass, capital V divided by the M. are won by the density, and specific gravity or relative density. The specific gravity is the ratio of density of a substance to the density of some standard substance at specific temperature. For liquid, we take water is the reference fluid, and for gaseous substances, we take air as the reference fluid. So, specific gravity is density of any liquid divided by density of water, or specific gravity is density of any gas to the density of air. So, rho by rho a. And the pressure, so which is an important thermodynamic property. Pressure is defined as force exerted per unit area. So, force per area. So, force exerted per area of the boundary, which is F by A, the unit is Pascal or Newtons per meter square. Force is in Newton and area is in meter square. So, in general, Newtons per meter square, but one Newtons per meter square equal to 1 Pascal. So, this is also Pascal. The unit of pressure is Newtons per meter square, which is also called as Pascal. And 1 Pascal equal to 1 Newtons per meter square. The other units of pressure are bar, standard atmosphere, and Clairaut force per square centimeter. And this is the sum of the conversion. 1 bar equal to 10 to the power 5 Pascal or 100 kilopascal. 1 atmosphere equal to 1.01325 bar. And 1 kilogram force per centimeter square equal to 9.807 10 power 4 Pascal or 0.9807 bar or 0.9679 atmosphere. So, these are all the conversion factors. But you have to remember, there is no other go. We have to remember all these equations for conversion. Normally, we require this 1 bar equal to 10 to the power 5 Pascal and 1 atmosphere equal to 1.01325 bar. So, this you have to remember. 1 atmospheric pressure equal to 1.01325 bar. And absolute pressure, gauge pressure and vacuum pressure. There are three pressures we are interested. One is absolute pressure. The pressure measured relative to the absolute vacuum is called as absolute pressure. The pressure measured relative to the atmospheric pressure is called as gauge pressure. So, gauge pressure using a pressure measuring instrument, the pressure what we measure using a pressure measuring instrument is the gauge pressure. Vacuum pressure, when the pressure is below the atmospheric pressure, is called as vacuum pressure. So, absolute pressure, the reference is absolute zero. The pressure measured with reference to the absolute zero pressure is called as absolute pressure. But the pressure measured with reference to the atmospheric pressure is called as gauge pressure, and the pressure below the atmospheric pressure is called as vacuum pressure. For all the cases, the reference pressure is there. And the relationship between all the three pressures, for positive pressure, so the positive pressure is pressure above the atmospheric pressure, negative pressure is pressure below the atmospheric pressure. So, pressure below the atmospheric pressure is known as vacuum pressure. So, for positive pressure, absolute pressure equal to the sum of gauge pressure plus atmospheric pressure. And negative pressure, the absolute pressure equal to atmospheric pressure minus the gauge pressure. Because negative pressure, pressure is less than atmospheric pressure. And this diagram will explain you. And the dotted line, so from the datum, absolute vacuum, this is the datum, absolute pressure equal to zero. We refer the atmospheric pressure. And the pressure below the atmospheric pressure is called as vacuum pressure. So, here we measure the absolute pressure and this pressure is called as gauge pressure. So, the gauge pressure is less than the atmospheric pressure. And the pressure what we measure below the atmospheric pressure is called as vacuum pressure, and the absolute pressure is atmospheric pressure minus the vacuum gauge pressure. And here you look at here, this is the atmospheric pressure. So, pressure above the atmospheric pressure is the gauge pressure. So, the absolute pressure is the sum of atmospheric pressure plus the gauge pressure. So, the here for positive pressure, this area is positive pressure. For positive pressure, the total height absolute pressure equal to atmospheric pressure plus the gauge pressure. And for negative pressure, so this is atmospheric pressure. So, the atmospheric pressure equal to absolute pressure plus vacuum pressure. Or the vacuum pressure, absolute pressure equal to atmospheric pressure minus the gauge pressure or the vacuum pressure. And this pressure is a scalar quantity. The instrument used to measure the pressure are manometer, bodon gauge or pressure transducer. Manometer is the standard instrument to measure the pressure. And the bodon gauge is the mechanical device to measure the pressure. and the pressure transducer, they are electrical equipment, electrical, they are working on the electrical principle to measure the pressure. Atmospheric pressure is measured by a device called barometer. So barometer is a device used for measuring the atmospheric pressure, and the standard atmospheric pressure is 760 millimeter of mercury at 0 degree Celsius or 760 millimeter of mercury equal to 1.01325 bar. So this pressure you have to remember, 760 millimeter of mercury you have to remember. And this is the boron gauge. So you tube manometer. So one side we have a mercury or any fluid is filled here. Suppose if you want to measure the pressure of a gas, we can have water. If you want to measure the pressure of liquid, you have to have the mercury, other fluid. So here the reference pressure is acting. Normally the atmospheric pressure is the reference pressure, and the pressure of the fluid is acting here. So the pressure difference between the column difference is measured. So from the column difference we measure the pressure. So the delta H is the column difference, and from the delta H we measure the pressure. And this is the boron pressure gauge. So where we look at here, we have a dial. So the pressure is given here, the pressure is acting inside, and the dial will indicate the pressure. Here inside we have the boron pressure gauge and some mechanical system to actuate to convert the pressure signal into the reading. And this is vacuum gauge, again the same type of boron gauge, but if the pressure is negative pressure, zero, less than zero atmospheric pressure, and here it is bar, it is millimeter of mercury. And this is the pressure transducer for measuring the pressure. So here we apply the pressure here. So we have a diaphragm. The diaphragm will sense the pressure, and the diaphragm will deflect, and the deflection of the diaphragm is sensed by a crystal, and the electrical output is given, and this electrical output is calibrated into pressure reading. So this diaphragm, deflection of the diaphragm is sensed by the crystal, and then we are producing electrical signal. The electrical signal is given to the amplifying unit and to measure the pressure. So this is the advanced equipment, advanced device, advanced measuring method used almost in all industrial practices. These are all the standard system. ETD manometer, boron pressure gauge, they are the standard pressure measuring devices. And the accuracy also will be better in these devices comparing with the pressure transducer. But all the equipment, all the devices, they require periodic calibration for accuracy of the result. And energy is defined as the capacity to do work. Energy is the capacity to exert your force through a distance. So the energy equal to force into distance, and the power is the rate of work done. Rate of energy transfer is called as power. Unit of power is joules per second or watt. So the SI system, unit for energy equal to newton meter or joule. 1 newton meter equal to 1 joule, and rate of power, unit of power equal to 1 watts or joules per second. And we stop here. We just reflect our learning in the past 13 minutes, and you can answer the questions here. Distinguish between intensive and extensive properties. You can give a pass to the video and write the answer in your paper, and you can verify the answer. Yes, the difference, distinguish between intensive and extensive property. Intensive property, they are independent of the mass of the system. And extensive property, they depend on the mass of the system, mass in the system. That is the difference between intensive and extensive properties. The unit of pressure, it may be newtons per meter square, pascal, bar, kilogram force per centimeter square. You can have anything. So you can write anything, any of the pressure. What do you mean by gauge pressure, vacuum pressure, and absolute pressure? So gauge pressure is measured with respect to with the help of a pressure gauge, pressure measuring instrument. For gauge pressure, the reference pressure is atmospheric pressure. Pressure measured above the atmospheric pressure is the gauge pressure. A pressure measured below the atmospheric pressure is the vacuum pressure. And for absolute pressure, the reference pressure is zero atmospheric pressure. So the absolute pressure is, the reference pressure for absolute pressure is zero absolute pressure. And DAS is used to measure the atmospheric pressure. You can write the name of the instrument. So the barometer is the instrument used to measure the atmospheric pressure. Barometer is used to measure the atmospheric pressure. And the unit of energy, newton meter or joule, and unit of power joules per second or watts. And we take the zeroth law of thermodynamics. We take the statement, the zeroth law of thermodynamics states when a body A is in thermal equilibrium with the body B and also separately with the body C, then B and C are in thermal equilibrium with each other. So we take three systems. A, body A, system A is in thermal equilibrium with the system B and system C separately. A is in thermal equilibrium with the B, A is in thermal equilibrium with the C. What do you mean by thermal equilibrium? The temperature of two systems are equal, A and B are equal, A and C are equal. So when the A and B are in equal temperature, that means they are in thermal equilibrium. When A and C are in the equal temperature, then it is called as, then A and C are in thermal equilibrium. When A and B and A and C separately thermal equilibrium with each other, then obviously B and C, they are in thermal equilibrium. That is what the statement. Zeroth law of thermodynamics states that when a body A is in thermal equilibrium with the body B and also separately with the body C, then B and C are in thermal equilibrium with each other. So are all the three systems, they are in equal thermal equilibrium. The zeroth law of thermodynamics was first formulated by R.H. Fowler in the year 1931. At that time, the first and second law of thermodynamics were already existed. So it was designated as zeroth law of thermodynamics. So this law was formulated in the year 1931, but the first and second law, they were earlier, so they were invented, they were formulated earlier than this period. So it is called as zeroth law of thermodynamics. And he is the man, Sir Ralph Howard Fowler, a British physicist and astronomer. In 1931, he was the first to formulate the label of zeroth law of thermodynamics. And the zeroth law of thermodynamics, it is the basis for temperature measurement. The temperature is the measure of hotness or coldness of a body. The instrument used to measure the temperature is called as thermometer. So the basics, actually using the zeroth law of thermodynamics, we identify a new property in thermodynamics, which is called as thermometer. So thermometer uses the thermometric property like height of mercury column to measure the temperature. So we require some property to measure the thermometer, temperature. The various devices used, various instruments used to measuring the temperature and thermometric property. Constant volume gas thermometer. So pressure. So using the pressure, gas pressure, we are measuring the temperature. Constant pressure gas thermometer. Using the volume of the gas, we measure the temperature. Alcohol or mercury in glass thermometer. Length of the mercury column. So this is very popular. Thermometer used by the doctors. Electrical resistance thermometer. So electrical resistance is used as a property for measuring the temperature. Thermocouple, electromotive force. So thermocouple is another device which is working on Seebeck effect to measure the temperature. And radiation pyrometer, this is called as non-contact type of temperature measuring instrument. So which is used to calculate the, to find out the temperature without touching the object, without touching the object or the source, radiation pyrometer. So intensity of radiation is the source of measurement, is the property of measurement. And the various scales for temperature measurement, very popular scales are Celsius, Fahrenheit and Kelvin and Rankine. So in, we will be using, frequently using Celsius, Kelvin and the Fahrenheit. Rarely we use the Fahrenheit for engineering calculation. Majority of the time we will be using Celsius and Kelvin. Rankine scale is not popular today, but the Fahrenheit scale is very popular. So doctors are measuring the body temperature in Fahrenheit, which is 98.4 degree Fahrenheit. And this is what the relationship between the three temperature scales, the popular temperature scales. So in all the temperature measurement, we require reference point. One reference point is freezing point of water. Another reference point is boiling point of water. This is the range. So the Celsius scale, freezing point is 0 degree Celsius and boiling point is 100 degree Celsius. For Fahrenheit scale, the freezing point is 32 degree Fahrenheit and for the boiling point is 212 degree Fahrenheit. And for the Kelvin scale, the freezing point is 273.15 Kelvin and the boiling point is 373.15 Kelvin. So there is some relationship between the Fahrenheit, Celsius and Kelvin scale and this is what the relationship. So Rankin equal to degree Fahrenheit plus 459.67, degree Fahrenheit equal to 1.8 into degree Celsius plus 32, and degree Kelvin equal to degree Celsius plus 273.15, and Rankin equal to degree 1.8 into Kelvin. So this is what the relationship, and we solve few numerical example using this relationship so that you get familiar. But for engineering, for in all our problems, we will be solving problem with the temperature either Celsius or Kelvin. And in SI system, we have to follow only the Kelvin scale for all our temperature measurement. And he is the man Celsius from 1727 November 1701 to 25th April 1744. He was a Swedish astronomer, physics and mathematician. He was a professor of astronomy in Uppsala University from 1730 to 1744. In 1742, he only proposed the centigrade temperature scale and named as in his name as Celsius. And he is the man Fahrenheit, Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit. He is a German physicist, inventor and scientific instrument maker. He is a pioneer exact thermometry. He helped to lay foundations for the era of precision thermometry by inventing mercury in glass thermometer, the first practical accurate thermometer, and the Fahrenheit scale. So the first scale used for measuring temperature and widely used. And we define this, just reflections part here. You pause the video for some time and answer to the question. Define, state the zeroth law of thermodynamics. Write the answer. Take few seconds, write the answer. Yes. Zeroth law of thermodynamics states that when a body A is in thermal equilibrium with the body B and separately with the thermal equilibrium with the body C, then body B and C, they are in thermal equilibrium. The property identified using the zeroth law of thermodynamics is, write the answer, check your memory. Temperature is the answer. The property identified using zeroth law of thermodynamics is temperature. Name the instrument used to measure the temperature. Thermometer and the thermocouple, radiation pyrometer. Name the scales used for measuring the temperature. Celsius scale, Fahrenheit scale and the Kelvin scale. These are all the three popular scales. And these are all the books, reference books I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And you can, if you have any queries, you can write to me to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer. Thanks for watching. And if you have any queries or comments on the video, you can pass the comments so that I will improve the video. So thank you very much for watching.